But you
So,
know,
do you have your evidence?
have it evidence that what a water level is a device that establishes a horizontal plane of reference?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, it's a equal altitude. All points of a water level will be an equal altitude.
And that includes evidence that a water level is completely horizontal, establishes horizontal no matter the distance, right?
Yes, that's what a water level is. It's a tool for establishing a horizontal plane of reference. Yes.
That was Rachie questioning Bear from Try Thinking about his claims regarding water levels. So I thought I'd construct some geometry to help me visualize what I believe is going on and maybe spot some of those horizontal planes of reference in the process. So this is my setup. You can see that I can alter the tube length. I can also alter the number of tubes, or I can alter the fill level. I'll leave that on 1.8 meters. We have a refraction slider, which I'll use later on. And I've also made this funny looking auto level, which I can move about. It's 1.8 meters tall, and we can see that all the riser tubes are all filled to 1.8 meters. Now, as I believe that the Earth is a globe, that's Earth with a capital E, then this green thing isn't a hump or a hill. This is curvature, and I believe this to be a level surface. And that means all these riser tubes, these are all oriented vertically.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, it's an equal altitude. All points of a water level will be an equal altitude.
So what does Bev mean by all points? If he's just talking about the fill levels in the riser tubes, that's point A and point B in this case, then I'm happy to be in agreement with him. But if he's talking about all the points that make up line AB, then I have to disagree. Now imagine pulling a string so tight between points A and B so that it doesn't sag, and then we were to measure the altitude of that string along its length. What would we expect to see? Well, our 1.8 meter value here will start to fall as we move it away from point A. And it will gradually come to a stop at the halfway point, which is here. After this point, it will start to rise until it reaches point B and it's back to 1.8.
It's a tool for establishing a horizontal plane of reference, yes.
So is there anywhere along the string that we can call horizontal? Well, that all depends on how strictly you want to define the word, but personally, I'm happy with calling the local area around the midpoint horizontal for the purpose of, say, building a garden shed. Maybe not for larger scale projects, though. Remember, the midpoint was 113 millimeters lower than both endpoints, and Bev probably thinks that's because the surface looks higher in the middle. It's not. The surface is level. 1.8 meters at this location would be above the string line. And notice we have two 90s for this location. We've got one for this angle here, and another for this angle here. This won't be the case for anywhere else on the string. So here I'm setting up the auto level to the same altitude as the water levels in both riser tubes, all being 1.8 meters above the level surface. Here we can see that 113 millimeter drop at both ends, refraction excluded, for this 2.4 kilometer span. So let me ask you this, would it have been a proper test to put this auto level at the midpoint, start it off low, say at 1 meter, and then gradually jack it up until both ends of the water level were aligned? Or, to say it another way, have the auto level at the correct altitude and then just top up the water level until they're all in line.
We did, for a laugh. We went out there with an auto level and we stretched the 100 meter water level out and we lifted the water level to the crosshairs on one side. And then we turned the auto level round, and surprisingly enough, it matched the water level on the other side as well.
But even if Bev managed to carry out this test correctly, would he have been really able to discern 0.2 millimetres? Even less if you include refraction.
So this is the tool, the level, and you look through and you see a crosshair on the other end. So that's what DP's doing here. And you can turn this through 360 degrees and you would see a horizontal crosshair all the way around. It always be horizontal. So when you have your level in the middle of these 100 meters, you can check the level at this end with the level at this end with this tool. And strangely enough, you'll find out that the water level equalizes to be a horizontal that can be checked. I mean, it's pretty simple. So you go, imagine this is 100 meters. This is where your water level is, the junction is, and you've got a T-junction that puts the water level up there, and it equalizes out. So you check that. Then you can move your auto level, pick it up, and move it this side. Move it 100 meters. Then you can level it up with this one, turn it all the way around, and check it with this one here. So you just keep doing that with this auto level, keeps moving along, and it goes all the way along to check the level at the other end, and it's a horizontal all the way across. Now, that is what it always has been to me, and it just makes logical and practical sense that is what happens.
Sorry about that. So Bev picks up the auto level, he moves it to a midpoint, and then aligns it with the water level. What he should have done is he should have measured the altitude of the water level and then independently adjust his auto level to match that altitude from the level surface. But at this distance, it's all a bit pointless anyway, because as you can see, we're only expecting 0.2 millimeters of drop. And it's even less, as I say, when you include refraction. And he'll do this again. Same and again. Same and again. So what I'd recommend to Bev for the next time he goes to Bedford is, and I'll make a bit of a prediction here, is to move the auto level next to riser number 1, get the staff out and place it next to riser 17, and then measure the drop from the crosshair, and you should see about 166 millimeters. Do it again if you like. Move the auto level to riser 17 and reverse it. Put your staff over here. Again, you'll see 166 millimeters drop. Put the auto level in the middle if you want. This time you'll see 41 millimeters at each end.
No, you did explain it. My only question would be, let's say each of those posts that you have on there, the three posts with the water level going up to the top are A, B, and C from left to right. What's to say that A and B and C, that there's not an angle between those two? What I mean is, right, how do you know A and C are also on a horizontal? We know A and B would, and B and C would, but how do we know A to C is up one long horizontal?
B and C, like that, right?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
All you do is you blank that off and you make A to C, that would be your horizontal, right? The water level allows you to do that.
Oh, dear. Well, that was a really good question. And what we can do to test this is we can go back to our string line. So we've got three risers. These are spaced out 100 each. And if I move B to over here, we should see this line change angle. It's very slight at this distance. If I introduce a few more tubes and then move the string line across all the levels, we can now see clearly that it's moving. It's highest there and lowest there. So I've not really gone through the script with this one. I'm not really planning on doing that. I can have a look at just some of these just now. Switch some of these off. Alpha, so that's L divided by R. This is the length divided by the radius. And that's the angle one tube will subtend. F, fittings, I've made that. So that's the fittings at the bottom, elbows and T's. And it's a sequence. It's pi over 2 is 90 degrees, so I'm rotating it from, say, if you've got north and east, south and west as cardinal points, 0 degrees is east. So I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees, that's pi over 2, and that will take us to this point here. And then the rest of it works out where I need to put the first one, and then the next in the sequence will be angle alpha along. T is the top of our tubes. Riser is our riser tubes. C will be our circular arc at the bottom. L is the level lines. That's those. And fill. That's where we fill it to. So it's just sequences, really. So a few lines can do a lot of things. So I'll make sure to leave a download link in the description. So yeah, that's going to be it for this one. Not my usual cup of tea. So I'd be interested in your thoughts down in the comments section. So yeah, just hit that like button for me if you can. And I'll catch you later.